No, no, one minute. Excuse me. No, kitab does not mean Jews and Christian. Or anywhere in any learned Arabic, you show me al-kitab means Jews and Christian. So that is your interpretation. I translate it. Thank you. Sorry? You can come over here. There's a mic also.
Ahl-e-Kitab, that's what he's referring to.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum.
My name is Khwaja.
Yes, sir.
I think what my brother is trying to say is that Ahl-e-Kitab means the holders of all the books revealed by God.
Sir, please.
That's what he's trying
right.
to
say. Right. Now again, you're also interpreting. Kutub means books. Al-Kitab means...
Kutub actually means the written word.
Written one. I know that. But it generally translates as Kitab and Kutub. Kutub generally translates as books. Yes.
When it says, Zalikal Kitab al-Arab,
excuse me.
It's not a debate. If I'm interpreting, you correct me, please. You can
no,
have the right.
I'm not interpreting. No, it's a translation.
Did I interpret? You have to tell me where did I interpret because he says, I interpreted.
Oh, no. You're translating.
Thank you very much. Please. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Excuse me, Mr. Sheikh. Here we are the Muslim. We have the Quran in Urdu and all possible translation languages in our houses. But now we are seeing all over the world, the Muslim people really in trouble, all the way. And especially we have seen in our society in Pakistan, the religious people really in a very, very bad condition. What is the reasons in Quran for all these things? And please mention the what is the solution of all these kind of problems. One man, he's Pesh Imam in the mosque. And when you will see his condition financially or any kind, you will feel very bad. Very bad condition he is. He is reading Quran. He is translating Quran. He giving the khutbah in Jummah and all these things. What is the reasons? Kindly give the answer through the Quran and what is the solution of all these problems. Kindly give the Qurani ayat, please. Thank you.
So I don't know what was your question. He wants me to comment on the Maulana now. You see, the point is I am not here to disgrace anybody. Everybody has to be judged according to the plan of Allah on the last day. I am not here to judge anybody. If you find somebody, a Maulana doing certain thing, Allah knows best. He will be judged on the last day. I can't pass a judgment. If he's finding problems in the world, in the Muslim world are finding problems, I told you, just ayat I read you, that among the people of the book are mumin, wa aktharum fasiqun, and the majority are the fasiqs. They are perverted transgressors. They are not doing the job. Wala tafarraqu. You see, I will read for you the same ayah. The ayah, the solution you are asking for in Surah Al-Imran, and that is 3102 and 103. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. That hold fast to Allah's rope and do not divide. That's the simple, you see, that's ayah, that's Allah saying that. So if you believe, you practice. If somebody doesn't practice, then he is on the unwilling submission then. He's doing it and he knows that he'll go to hellfire. He knows that. He's still doing it. But you have to show it to him. So Allah says, وَعَتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. All of you hold fast to rope of Allah. وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. And do not be divided. So this is ayat. If you believe that, we do our job. We should not be divided. But if you say, look, he's doing it, if you can ask him, look, the Quran says that, and he says, I don't care. So leave me about. Allah will judge him on the last day.
My name is Babar. I would like to ask you a question about Surah Baqarah and in ayat 62. It is mentioned, in America, in North America, and especially in Europe, the people are questioning about this ayat, which make them understand, like anybody, Jewish and the Christian, if they believe in God and the Day of Judgment, and if they believe in God and the Day of Judgment, the God will forgive them or give them a reward, and they will be in heaven. what you say about that? Surah Baqarah, yeah. And 62.
You see, he's referring to chapter 2, that is Baqarah, and ayah 62. The ayah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالنَّصَارَى وَالصَّابِئِينَ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. I will read the translation which he was trying to say. Those who believe in the Quran and those who follow the Jewish scriptures and the Christians and the Sabians, whoever believes in Allah and the last day and walk righteousness, shall have their reward with their Lord. On them shall be no fear, nor shall they grieve. You see, Quran, first of all, if some Christian or some anybody non-Muslim who points out this verse, I would like to give you two answers. First, a logical answer. If he says this ayah refers to Christians, and if they believe in God and the last day, then no fear. So ask a Christian, do you believe in Allah, to accept the statement? If a Christian shows you a Quranic ayah and says that whether I be a Christian, I believe in God, and the last day I will go to hell. Look, your Quran says I will go to heaven. So ask a Christian, do you believe in Allah of the Quran? You're quoting me a Quranic ayah. So your Jannah is depending on Quranic God, on Quranic Allah. If Allah says that there is no fear on you, you believe that. So he will say no. So how can you show a Quranic ayat because he doesn't believe? Then here the ayat is referring to who believe in Allah. And I mentioned in my lecture 2,697 times that Allah with above 99 attributes. Not God of Father, Son and Holy Ghost. Not that God. He has got the concept of the God that is a biblical God or whatever, the Christian God. When he says, quote the Quranic ayat, to ask him, do you believe in Allah? And Allah is mentioned in the Quran 2,697 times and 99 above attributes, personality, and he is not the Son of God. He is not the Father, the Son and Holy Ghost. That Allah you are talking about? So he will say, no. So he is not referring to him. So now the Christian word is there. So now the ayah is how the Quran, if you read again, he says, those who believe and those who follow the Jewish scriptures and the Christians and the Sabians, whoever believes in Allah, if you are labeled as, suppose if I'm a Christian, born in Christian West or Christian environment, I was a Christian, labeled as a Christian, but now I believe in Allah in the last day, so I'm reverting to Islam. But I know some of the Muslims, we will say, no, he may be not a Christian, he's still a Christian, he's not a Muslim. We call him a Christian, and I know people he's converted to into Islam because he's a white man, he will take him as a Christian. Masjid, in the mosque, that guy is a Muslim and he's reverted to Islam, and people still consider him as a Christian. So they will label him as a Christian, still he's offering namaz, better Muslim than you. So that is why Allah says, whether you are a Christian or whether you label as a Jew, whatever, if you have believed in Allah in the last day, your reward is with us. Don't bother with these people. So that is how the ayah answers that. It is not that way. It is. You see, I'm not very understanding. Who gave this? Can you? The question is not being clear. Huh? Yes? Please. I can't understand. It's you. Yes, please.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My name is Sohail Ali. You have given us proof from the verses of the Quran that Islam and Muslims have existed in all times. Can you also show us that the Shara has also been the same during this entire period? For example, we are told that alcohol, drinking of alcohol was halal before the period of Muhammad. It was prohibited after that. Can you clarify that the Shara has been the same?
Okay. You see, generally it has been thought like that the Shara or the law was different. Like, for example, they say, Moses brought a law, then Jesus came, he wanted to confirm the law, and he brought some amendments. And finally, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam brought further law. So there are different laws and stages, and Islam evolved like into pieces. Look, there's a very common sense. Allah is almighty. He gives a religion, perfect religion, a religion of all times. So now, his question is that the word the shara'al, the law was the same, or it amended or changed? So we look into the Quran, the law is the same. And the proof is in Shura 42, I will read for you. In Arabic it reads, sounds like that, shara'a, shara'a means the law. شَرَعَ لَكُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا وَصَّى بِهِ نُوحًا وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ وَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِهِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى أَنْ أَقِمُ الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. The translation is, the same shara or the law has he enjoined for you as that which he enjoined on Nuh or Noah, that which he has sent by inspiration to thee, that is Prophet, peace be upon him, and that which he enjoined on Ibrahim, the same Shura, and Musa alayhi salam, and Isa alayhi salam, namely that you should remain steadfast in religion and make no division therein. Again I repeat, Shara'a lakum min ad-deen ma wassa bi Nuhan walladhi awhayna ilayka وَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِهِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَىٰ أَنْ أَقِمُ الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. The same shara or the same law has he enjoined or established for you as that which he enjoined on Nuh, the ancient prophet, that which he have sent by inspiration to thee, that is Prophet, peace be upon him, and that which he enjoined on Ibrahim, Musa, Moses, Isa, Jesus, namely that you should remain steadfast in religion and make no division. The shara was same in all times. There is no difference of shara. But since, because of the prevailing different, like Bible, there is a law. Then there is other religious books. Then there is a, so this, but according to that, they say, look, Jesus brought this, and Moses brought that, and so Muhammad brought Quran. You know, it is like four books, like it's like this. So, you see, the shara is the same and the law is the same, the book is the same, and the religion of Allah, Islam, is the same. There was no change at any time.
There's a question that was given by Tony.
Actually, the question is a simple one.
Yes, please.
You refer to, in I think 3162, die not except as a Muslim. In 1092, again it says that if you die, at the time of death, Pharaoh asked for forgiveness but was not forgiven, implying that last minute reprieve is not granted by Allah. What happens to the person who believes, now if it is possible and you could clarify from the, a person who believes all his life, who is a mu'min, and for some reason he becomes an apostate or he disbelieves. How would, is there something with reference to that in the Quran?
You mean to say at the last minute he will become a non-believer? That you are trying to say that?
If it's possible.
It's possible. I understand. No, sorry. Thank you very much. I understand. The question is that I read an ayah that the Pharaoh, in the last moment of his life, he became a believer. He wanted to be a believer. He wanted to be submitting. He wanted to become a Muslim at the last moment of Pharaoh's life. So he was a non-believer, he wanted to be a believer. So the question, the gentleman is asking a question that suppose a person is a believer all his life, and then in the last minute he becomes a non-believer. That is the question. So I'm not giving you a particular verse, but on a general comprehension and the reading of the translation of the Quran, at the last minute, a person who is a good believer or a practicing Muslim, Allah takes his life with salam, with peace. And the one who is a non-believer, he bash him up in the Quran. So general reading says that a believer at the last minute will be, when he's passing his life, he'll be going to Allah happily. He can't change. It is not possible. Because he was practicing reality and he is heading to reality. So he can't change. until unless he become unconscious or something he loses head. But normally, according to the Quran, when he's coming into his last minute, Allah says they will be said, Salam, come and enter into Jannah in Surah Yasin. There's a fellow, Allah, you read Yasin and you see that ayah. That the last, he said, oh, come on, believe in. And then Allah said, come, Salam, he gets into Jannah. The last moment of anybody's life, he sees the reality. So we can understand by example of Pharaoh is that the last moment of anybody's life, he sees the reality. That is why he became a Muslim. Because Pharaoh saw the reality. So all of his all of anybody's life, he's practicing good Muslim. That means he is in reality. He can't go wrong. That is my simple logic. I can't exactly quote particular ayah. Yes, please. You want to narrate that question?
Do we have any other further questions?
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Namuduna Salli Allah Rasulil Kareem. Mr. Sheikh, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu Alaikum. It is always very exhilarating to listen to you. Now the sects are forbidden by Quran, but we've got a lot of sects and they're doing a lot of damage. I think Islam has been damaged mostly by the sects. And I think the non-Muslims, they always try to, I think, play up these sects, and a lot of damage is done. Now what should be the program to rectify the situation? Because if we keep on just, going like that, I think we will become a wreck. Already we are a wreck. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I think this is just a comment. Again, I repeat to the same awaq, tasimu bi hablillahi jamia wa la tafarraqu. Hold fast to Allah's rope and do not make divisions. That's the comment. That's the ayah of the Allah statement. If you are not following, so we know our destiny. If you are not following the ayat, wa tasimu bi hablillahi jamia wa la tafarraqu, hold fast to Allah's rope and do not divide therein. If people we are not doing, then we will suffer for our actions.
Thank you.
Bismillahir Rahman Rahim. My name is Saleem Ahmed, and Sheikh Sahib, you quoted Surah Hajj and Ayah 78, in which what I have understand is that in religion it is the cult of your father Ibrahim. It is he who has named you Muslims. I have not been very clear about this statement that it is the cult of your father Ibrahim. Will you please say something more about this? Thank you.
He's quoting from Surah Hajj, Bais 22 chapter and Ayah 78. And the Quran says, وَجَاهِدُوا فِي اللَّهِ أَقَّ جِهَادِي, and strive in his cause as you are to strive. هُوَ جِتَبَاكُمْ وَمَا جَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ, and he's chosen you and has made no difficulties in your religion. مِلَّةَ أَبِيكُمْ إِبْرَاهِيمِ. It is the millat or the system, or the, he translated there in the translation, is the cult of your father Ibrahim. He's asking for more clarification on millate Ibrahim. So I would like him to refer to Surah Anam 6, and ayah is 161. I will read, قُلْ إِنَنِّي هَدَانِي رَبِّي إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ دِينًا قِيَمًا مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. The translation is, say, verily my Lord has guided me to a way that is straight, a religion of right, the path of Ibrahim, the true in faith, and he joined not gods with Allah. So in the Surah Fatiha, the 6 or 5 ayat is Ihdina Sirat al Mustaqim. Again and again, we Muslim world pray 5 times a day, and every rakat asks help from you. Ihdina Sirat al Mustaqim. And we says, guide us onto the straight path. Guide us onto the straight path. And here Allah says, قُلْ say, إِنَّنِي هَدَانِي رَبِّي لَا صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Say that Allah has guided مستقيم. And that path is deenan qiyamam, deen, religion that establish millata Ibrahim hanifa, that religion in the world today exists because of millata Ibrahim hanifa. Wama kana millal mushrikeen, and he was not of the associates. So millata Ibrahim is the religion established today. Hajj, umrah, salat, everything the Muslim community does is millata Ibrahim, and that is the straight path. And Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam established the same path. The further ayah says, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَالنُّسُكِي وَمَحْيَيَا وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Say truly, my prayer, my salah, my service of sacrifice, my life, my death are for Allah, the cherisher of the worlds. Further he says, لَا شَرِيكَ اللَّهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. No partners as he. This I am commanded, that I am of the first of the Muslims. The first of the Muslims, you have to be. The first of the Muslim in history was Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The first of the Muslim, anybody has to take a stand that we are following Millat Ibrahim. That is what Quran is quoting us, that we have to say that. All these ayahs start with say. So Millat Ibrahim is the religion brought by Ibrahim alaihi salam, and it is a religion established. Hajj, Umrah, everything is by Millat Ibrahim, and all the Muslims practicing the same religion.
Thank you. Any? We will entertain maybe one or two more questions. After this, we will have a closing.
My name is Farid. I would like to ask you a question. You have said that we don't make any distinction between prophets. But what about Muhammad, peace be upon him? Is he the leader of the prophets?
Him, the seal of the prophets. What is the status? The detail is the lecture to be followed. You can most welcome. But a short verse I can quote at the moment, and that is Surah Azab 33 and 40 ayat. Ma kana Muhammadun aba ahadim min rijalikum walakin rasulullahi wa khataman nabiyyin wa kana Allahu bikulli shay'in alima. The translation is, Muhammad is not the father of any one of you, of your men. He is the messenger of Allah and seal of the prophets. Khataman nabiyyin, the seal of the prophets. So all the prophets pulled together, he is the seal of the prophets. So that is the status given by Allah for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You see, if I give you, I can explain this by this, if I give you a blank sheet signed by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the seal. You understand the word seal? The seal. Seal, you understand. Now, that blank sheet is just a blank. He's a seal of what? So if I write down Ibrahim alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, Dawud, all the names of the Prophet, if you know all the Prophet's personalities written down there, then you understand Khatam al-Nabiyyin. He's the seal of the Prophets. So you must know all the Prophet's character to know Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So according to the Quranic status is that he is the seal of the Prophets. And what you mean by Imam or leader, every Prophet is Imam and leader.
Thank you. We'll take one more question if there is.
Mr. Sheikh, you mentioned in an answer that nobody can die like this whole life. He says la ilaha illallah, salat and hajj, all these things. Last time he says as dying a non-Muslim. I have an example in India last year, I think, Asmat Chughtai, her name Asmat Chughtai, and he advised his families, she advised his families that please don't give a grave, just burn to me. What is the answer? Thank you.
I understand. You see, the we must understand the we must understand Muslim not in your point of view, not in my point of view. I am trying to say again and again, Muslim in the sight of Allah, not a label. You see, when I was giving the answer to the previous questioner, I was trying to say that if a person is in reality, Allah knows, and that gentleman knows, he lived his life all through the laws mentioned in the Quran. And on the day of judgment, on the last day, Allah knows. So if my name is Muhammad Sheikh, I don't know, according to you, I'm a Muslim or not. But if I die, how do you know that I'll go to heaven or hell? That is the problem, whether I was a Muslim by name or by practice. Even if you see my practice, still you can't say, because Allah knows. So according to Allah's book, he has not mentioned anywhere that a believer reverted into a non-Muslim at the last minute. But it was the other way around, that the last minute is the most important moment of anybody's life. He sees the reality, chances is to see the reality, you become a Muslim. That's the clue. That is the religion. Islam is the true religion. Allah exists. So he sees the reality. He would like to see the reality and become, we want to be in those. So not the other way around. But again, I'm telling you, Muslim in the sight of Allah. Allah is named, Huwa Sammakumul Muslimin. It is he who has named us Muslim. Not Muhammad Sheikh, born in Pakistan, and my father was a Muslim and I'm a Muslim. Not like that. Allah is named us. So we have to be, and then again, Ibrahim alayhi salam says that my dua, Rabbana waj'alna muslimaini laka. He's a prophet of God. His religion we are practicing, Millat Ibrahim Hanifa. But he is asking, Rabbana waj'alna muslimaini laka. Oh, our Lord, make us Muslims in thy sight. Waj'alna muslimaini laka. Wa min dhurriyatina ummatan muslimatan lak. And raise of an ummat Muslim in sight of Allah, not each other's sides, our sides. Our sides can go wrong. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Last of all, I'd like to thank sincerely, I'm sure from your behalf and my behalf, the chairman of the International Propagation Center, Mr. Muhammad Sheikh, for having spared his time and given us this highly revealing insight to the word Islam and Muslim. If you'd like, you can please bring your friends along as well. Thank you again so much for coming. Khuda Hafiz.